All right, what's going on, you guys? Nick here with Nick Strength and Power. I've got a couple of interesting stories for you guys today. The first story, let's go ahead and talk about Nick Walker here. So Nick posted an interesting video on his Instagram page, actually measuring his biceps. Now, this is something I was kind of curious about for a while, because obviously one of the standout features of Nick's physique is the insane size of his arms. I mean, his bicep peaks are practically mountains. Even people that dislike Nick's physique, it's hard to look at his physique and not acknowledge the fact that he's got some pretty insane arms. He's certainly got pro-caliber arms. He did this collaboration with Seth Ferosi, actually, at Attila's Gym. You guys have probably seen that on the news, that gym on the news recently, where he officially measures his biceps at 22¾ inches, almost 23 inches. That is Jay Cutler and Ronnie Coleman bicep territory. That is some of the best Mr. Olympia winners ever, bicep size territory. And the guy is not even pro yet. And in addition to that video, Nick Walker also posted this physique update. You know he had to do it, a front double bicep. Of course, he's looking to be in fantastic shape. He's, what, 3 weeks out now from the North Americans? So you guys already know the front double bicep is going to be insane, so that should not be, that should not come as a surprise to you. Look at the back double bicep here, another physique update. He looks like he's in actually really good condition. Now, the question is going to be the glutes and hamstrings. If that conditioning matches the rest of his body, that's going to be the main indicator of how good of shape he really is in. And we haven't seen that yet, but we will see when he gets on stage if he's able to bring that conditioning. I'm telling you guys, if he comes conditioned, he will get his pro card. He will win that show. And in addition to that, he posted this picture. They're talking about a waist like I got one. That's another criticism that I've seen of Nick Walker, is that his waist is thick. And I'll give you this. His waist, it's obviously not small. He's got a small waist for his physique. Small is a relative term. So when I say he's got a pretty good V-taper and a pretty small waist, that's relative to his size. A small waist is like Brian Buchanan. Google Brian Buchanan and you'll see what a small waist is. That's a small waist relative to anybody. But Nick, relative to his size, has a small waist. I understand. And people still criticize Nick and say, look, he's not aesthetic. He's not classic. He doesn't have those lines. My point is, for his size, he is. Obviously, aesthetic and classic, that's all. Those are relative terms too. But for his size, I think he is aesthetic. So let me know what you guys think in the comment section below about Nick Walker's current physique and whether or not you think he's going to get that pro card here in a few weeks now. Now, next up in the news, Patrick Moore. So Patrick Moore actually sent me this physique update, a front double bicep shot. Another guy who is known for having a tremendous front double bicep, speaking of Nick Walker. And he looks really good here. And he actually confirmed to me that he's going to be doing both, or at least the plan is, he's going to be doing both New York and California, is the plan so far. Now, I'm assuming that's only the plan if he doesn't win New York, because obviously if he won the whole New York Pro, he wouldn't really need to compete in California because he's qualified for the Olympia then. I wish there was like a complete competitor list for New York, because I have a general idea of some people that are doing it. Now we know that Patrick is doing it. I know that John De La Rosa is planning on doing it. He posted up a physique update as well, so I'll show you guys that. John De La Rosa is another guy that could be a serious contender at this show. I think that Ian Valliere is doing the New York Pro now that we know he's actually not retiring from bodybuilding. So that would be another pretty big name in that New York Pro lineup. And then I also believe that Dwayne Walker, the fan favorite from the New York Pro, a lot of people made the argument that Dwayne could have been second to Hunter at the New York Pro, or should have been second to Hunter at the New York Pro. And I've seen a lot of people actually make the argument that he was robbed at that show, and I could definitely see that side of the coin, because he had a really impressive physique, and really the word that I would use to describe Dwayne's physique was polished. He had an extremely polished physique. His conditioning was good. Just everything about his physique really impressed me for a guy that really we hadn't heard too much about prior to Tampa. So I think I'm pretty sure that Dwayne is jumping in that New York Pro lineup. So you've got De La Rosa, Patrick Moore, possibly Ian Valliere, Dwayne Walker. I'm not entirely sure who else is going to be doing it. I mean, the New York Pro is usually a pretty stacked lineup, but we haven't really seen any official competitor list yet. So we've at least got that to look forward to, the New York Pro, the Cali Pro. Shout out to Patrick Moore for sending me that physique update, and let me know what you guys think in the comment section below about how Patrick is looking. I always appreciate that. Now, next up in the news, Talking about the Mr. Olympia 2020, there is the possibility that the Olympia is going to be a pay-per-view event this year, with the possibility that limited attendance or possible no attendance. Who really knows what's going to happen with the Olympia as far as attendance is concerned? A lot could change between now and December, so who knows? But Jake Wood recently went on the new Digital Muscle Media show, Monday Night Muscle, with Bob Ciccarello. And one of the things they discussed was the future of the Mr. Olympia going forward. And interestingly, the topic of pay-per-views came up. And he said, here's his quote from the interview: "Provided that we can work out plans and achieve the things we want to achieve, we may be announcing some things regarding pay-per-view here in the future." I'm assuming this was in the context of this year's Mr. Olympia. There's moving parts on it. There's a lot of moving parts on it. That was one of the big developments that we really wanted to put forward this year. But because we had to change hotels and deal with all that, it kind of got pushed back. Now we're trying to play a little bit of catch up. So I've said for a long time, and I've said this about every show, that live streaming and pay-per-views is the future of bodybuilding, whether it's the Olympia or the smallest level pro show. I think making these shows accessible to fans via live stream, via the internet, that's the future of bodybuilding. Because think, a lot of these shows, the realistic aspect of them is in-person attendance is maybe 1,000 people. Think of how many people could access a live stream that want to watch these pro shows versus, you know, before, what they could physically handle in attendance capacity. Now, the Olympia obviously is thousands upon thousands. I think close to 20,000, I want to say, would be the Orleans Arena. So I'm really excited about what Jake brings to the table, because if you guys aren't really familiar, he purchased the Olympia this year. He's the third owner of the Olympia in Olympia history. It went from Joe Weider to American Media and then to Jake Wood. So it went from a corporate ownership, a corporate entity owning bodybuilding owning the Olympia, that essentially didn't have much personal fan-based interest in the Olympia. And Jake talks about in this interview with Bob how he's been a lifelong fan of bodybuilding. He talks about training at Vince Guaranda's gym. And if you guys don't know, Jake also basically single-handedly saved female bodybuilding with his Wings of Strength organization. So I think in a way, he's going to also be the savior of the Olympia if he really focuses and dials in on making the live stream experience a professional one. I know in the past, you know, we've been able to watch the Olympia live stream for several years now, and I know in the past there have been some terrible Olympia live streams, super laggy, cuts out, pauses, blackouts. The live stream in the past, there has been some really, really bad ones, and for this to be the highest caliber show in bodybuilding, I mean, it's kind of unacceptable to have that. And I think that Jake realizes that, and going forward, he's probably going to, if he does do a live stream pay-per-view, I think it's going to be top-notch. All right, now the final story that I've got for you guys, Juju Mufu with another physique update, morning physique check that he posted up on his Instagram story. Now, we talked about Juju a couple videos ago and whether or not he should compete in a bodybuilding show or a classic physique show or what we wanted to see him compete in, because he was contemplating competing again. And Juju commented that video. And like myself, it seems like Juju pays attention to the comments. So he said on that video, he said, "Wow, Nick, thank you for the shout-out and the vote of confidence. So cool to see this. Lots of respect for you. I'm going to scroll through some opinions here and see what class and show people think I should enter. Juju." So again, I want you guys to comment in the comment section below what you would like to see, where you would like to see Juju compete. Again, I'm not entirely sure what his height and weight is. I think he's under 6 foot. So if we're talking about classic physique, of course there's height and weight restrictions in that category, in that division. So that would kind of limit his possibilities if he wouldn't fit into any of those categories. But I do think he's got a classic look to his physique, more so than a mass monster look to his physique. If you had to put him on a spectrum somewhere between mass monster and classic, I would say he tilts a little bit more towards classic. So let me know what you guys think in the comment section below. Please give this video a thumbs up if you enjoyed it. Please subscribe to this channel if you have not subscribed yet already. And I'll probably have another video for you guys later tonight. And as always, Nick Strength and Power, signing out. I love you and appreciate you guys.